Before you enjoy the video, I would like to mention that over 85% of my viewers aren't subscribed. If you're part of 85%, consider subscribing as it helps me grow, thus producing better and more content for everybody. I would also like to mention that I'm doing a big giveaway once we reach 500 subscribers, so let's all get together and reach the goal. Without further ado, enjoy the video. Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Smojo and welcome back to another episode of New Card. If you guys don't know, this is a series on my YouTube channel where I take community made cards and see if they could fit into the game, if anything, what the card should change damage wise, pip wise, utility wise, and if it should just in general be a great addition. In this episode we will be talking about the Court Master card. I have to look at the name because I kind of forgot. The Court Master card is a balance card that hits all of the enemies and does damage over time, which is super interesting. If I could think about a card that's similar to this, it would be Deer Knight, because it is an AoE spell and it does do damage over time. Now the special thing about this card is that it doesn't have a certain amount of pips. It depending on the amount of pips that you have will depend on the amount of damage that you do. So for example, if we're looking at something like Judgment, the more pips that you have when you use Judgment, the more damage that you're going to do. Or Heckhound, the more pips that you have using Heckhound, the more damage that you are going to do. This card is basically just a Judgment meets AoE in a nutshell. Just imagine if Judgment was an area of damage card. Now the question stands, would this card be a good card for balance, or would it be too overpowered? If so, what should change about it, and how would we make it a good card to fit into the game? Now I did ask the community over on Reddit what they think about this card, and I asked some Discord people what they think about this card. If they think it's overpowered, what do they think should change about the card, or how would they make it better? So I'm just gonna read off a few comments and respond to them. One person on Reddit said, "To all enemies should cost 2 shadow pips." So they're basically saying that this card is super overpowered and it should cost at least 2 shadow pips to use. Now I'm not sure, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm not sure if there's any cards in the game that cost 2 shadow pips except one, and it's for you to donate a shadow pip to someone else. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure there's no attack cards in the game that cost 2 shadow pips. I'm not sure if I'm with the idea of 2 shadow pips. I feel like shadow pips aren't as easy to come by as regular pips, as everybody knows. So to get 2 of them just to hit with this card, I'm not sure would be a great idea. He also states that balance and ice have almost the same amount of damage spells. If ice is 1 shadow pip spell, is it 85 damage per pip to all? This is definitely a 2 shadow pip spell. He must be talking about Snowball Barrage when he's talking about 85 damage per pip to everyone. In a sense, he does have a point, considering this does 100 damage and the snow spell does 85. And on top of that, it does a DOT of 30 damage per pip. So yeah, this spell would definitely be overpowered. Now that I think about it, this spell would super, super, super be overpowered. If I were to change it, I would take that 100 and maybe bring it down to like a 50 or maybe a 60 or something less than 100, basically something that does less base damage than the barrage, and you could still keep the damage over time to make the card even more special. Now another spell that came into mind is Tempest, which is a storm spell you get very early in the game, which does 80 damage per pip to all enemies, which is very close to Snowball Barrage, which does 85 damage per pip to all enemies, but it also includes a shadow pip. That's a 5 damage difference for only a shadow pip. If Tempest wasn't in the game, I feel like if people were to introduce Tempest in the same way that I'm introducing this card, people would say that Tempest would be overpowered if they were to compare it to Snowball Barrage. Now, since Tempest does 80 damage per pip to all enemies, and Snowball Barrage does 85 damage per pip to all enemies, but you need a shadow pip, to change this card, we have to make it 60 base damage without any DOT and no shadow pip. I say about 60 through 70, just a number between 60 and 70. We could do 60, we could do 65, we could do 70. I just don't think this card should be stronger than Tempest, considering that Storm is supposed to be one of the strongest classes in the game. And if you introduce a card to the game that's just like Tempest, but it's for balance, but it's stronger than Tempest, I feel like it would bring some unbalance to the game. So overall, get rid of the DOT, don't add a shadow pip, have it be 60 through 70 base damage. Now if we were to keep the DOT, I think the damage should be brought down to 50 base damage and maybe a 30 DOT. No, I take that back. I'd say it needs to be a 60 base damage and a 30 DOT. That way it still does more damage than Tempest, but you do have that DOT there. So it doesn't do more damage in one hit, it does more damage overall. Now another person said get rid of the DLT and make it do 70 and 30 DLT, and another person said get rid of the DLT or make it do 70 and 30 DLT and make it cost a shot uphill, which I would agree with the second part, the 70 and the 30, because it is doing 100 damage overall, but it's also costing a shadow pup and it is a DLT, so I think that will make it a little bit more balanced. So yeah, I do agree with this guy. I think that would probably balance out the card and it would bring a new card to the game for balance, because I don't think balance has a DLT in the game at all. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I really don't think they do. Granted, I don't have a balance and I've never made a balance, so yeah. Now one thing popped up, somebody asked, does the 100 also change with the number of pips you use? Now that is a game changer, because if the 100 stays still and no matter how many pips you have, that 100 damage is always there, and the only thing that changes is the 30, that introduces a whole nother thing, because to me that's kind of like Minotaur, one of those spells that hits one time with a weak hit and then hits another time with the actual real hit, which could come in handy if somebody has a tower shield. You can hit one time, take out the tower shield, and hit another time and actually deal the damage that you want to deal to them, which would be very vital in PvP. Although I do doubt the card was made for that, because it does do more damage in the first hit than the DOT. For example, if it was for that, I think it would have said it do 30 damage plus 100 damage over time per pip per enemies. That's how, that way the first initial hit would be your weakest hit, and then the second hit or the DOT hit would be the stronger hit. Either way, I think it's a pretty cool card, and the artwork on it is amazing. I'm not sure who made the card. I will try to hunt down the person who made the card and leave them some recognition in the description down below. If you have any cards you would like for me to review, join the Discord, send the card, or DM me on any platform. I'm available anywhere. But yeah, I think it's a pretty cool card. Could probably change the values a little bit for it to actually fit into the game and not be too overpowered, but not be too weak, and still be a vital card that balances will use. But yeah, that's about it, guys. Thank you for watching. I'll see you on the next episode. I'm Smojo, and yeah, have a great day.